Hello, this is Catherine Calarco. Welcome. Today we have the honor to talk to Tremaine Richard-Noel, who's the head of emerging technology at Northampton General Hospital NHS Trust. Tremaine, you've been doing some phenomenal work deploying RPA at NHS. Please tell us a little bit about the journey you're on and how you've been able to quickly respond to the COVID pandemic.
So since COVID, our sort of use of RPAs really got started, and the innovation agenda in the NHS has sort of grown since COVID. So the need to sort of rapidly deploy new technologies and become more efficient has really how we got started. So we developed our first bot around March, and then we've taken a period to really sort of reflect on the areas we can start looking at across the whole organisation. And now we're in the sort of phase two of COVID. We're looking at all sorts of areas that we can deploy.
Tell us a little bit about the oxygen bot and what outcomes have you seen from RPA?
So in terms of outcomes, efficiency is obviously like one of the outcomes you get with RPA, but on some of the softer side of things, it's actually like things around the team being more energized and being able to, you know, try a new tool. Also seeing people starting to think about processes differently. So I've had people come up to me and say, look, I found a use case for a bot. So getting people excited about RPA has been a real change. Also, it's acted as a catalyst. So now people are thinking about technology and other ways they can use RPA. So also looking at like machine learning. And actually, when we're talking about new technologies, I think RPA has kind of made them less fearful of the new technologies out there. So it's been interesting. And also, you know, having people trained in it from all different backgrounds means that it feels like we've kind of had this team effort. So it's not only the efficiency, but really the sort of spirit it's had across the organization.
Tremaine, it's excellent what you've been able to achieve. I would love to share some of your key lessons and learnings with others. Tell us a little bit about what advice you would give others who are looking to scale across their organization.
So for us, getting as much buy-in as possible was important. I think that's important in every organization. So RPA is commonly misunderstood. So working with the execs down has been useful to sort of get buy-in and that to be cascaded down the organization. Also, I think one other piece of advice would be sort of getting sight of what other organizations have done. So I found it really useful to show our teams what other people have done with RPA, which gave us confidence then to start our journey. Also that the process discovery part is right. So actually having a wide enough pool to choose from. So really, and we found really working with teams almost one-on-one intensively to discover processes has been the best way, rather than just saying, we're here, tell us what you want us to do. And the final part is probably around sharing the successes. So having a sort of bot pipeline that everyone can see. So it becomes an organizational journey. So those have been really the three or four areas, actually.
That's amazing, Tremaine. You know, you really have solidly implemented RPA at the NHS. And I'd love to learn a little bit more about where you're taking it next. You're working on strategies. You're working on being able to scale this further across the NHS and truly transform healthcare. What's the future for you?
So for us, we're looking at proliferating RPA, not only in the back office, but now looking at the front, let's say the front office, but the clinical side, and looking at where RPA can be used there. Also excited to see how machine learning starts. We can use machine learning with bots, and also looking at how we can become more efficient with discovering processes. So really keen to see how to start using the discovery bot and see how that benefits our sort of acceleration of our program, really.
Thank you, Tremaine. It is amazing for you to share with us the insights that you've been able to achieve today. Not only that, the strategy that you're going to implement to take this further and how you're really enabling NHS to transform healthcare. This is inspiring, not for only ourselves, but actually others who are listening to this video or watching today. For those of you who are watching, please partner with Automation Anywhere. We are here for you to help you deliver and enable you to actually achieve the same results you've seen from Tremaine today.